everyone. Thanks for joining me. Today we are just going to do a full rounded yogic practice with a bit of breath work at the beginning. So, hop into something nice and comfortable and come and join me on the mat. I have moved into my lovely new house, which we've been renovating over the last year. So, loads of space. Let's get started in a nice, comfortable seated position, whatever that looks like for you. A nice long spine, relaxed shoulders, having your chin in neutral just so your neck is nice and long. And just let your hands relax on your legs, on your lap, or chi mudra if you prefer to sit in a mudra with thumb and index finger touching in a nice round circle, just balancing our energy. So closing our eyes. We'll begin just by bringing ourselves into our practice, bringing awareness to our body, to our breath. Let go of the day so far. Let go of thoughts. And just start focusing on your internal body, on your breath, just noticing what your body's feeling like today. Any areas of tension, just letting it go. Start to slow down the breath, lengthen the breath. Nice full yogic breaths, using all of our diaphragm. It's full capacity as we take our inhales from our belly all the way up to our chest. And then letting go of the breath as we exhale from the chest down towards the belly. So nice, big, conscious breaths, just for a few rounds. You're bringing that mind focus to the body. I'm trying not to force the breath. Create any tension in the body as we lengthen the breath. So just go to whatever comfortable length is for you. And eventually, as your body gets used to it, you'll be able to take deeper and deeper breaths. So just as long as you're consciously breathing, not just from your chest, but making that breath a little bit longer, a little bit fuller. And each new breath, or each new few breaths, seeing if you can take it that little bit. And just noticing as you continue with your long breath, if you're holding on to any tension in the body, the face nice and relaxed, letting go of any tension in the forehead, any tension in the jaw, just softening the face. A nice long relaxed neck, shoulders are relaxed, just having them slightly drawn back towards each other, just so the spine is, the chest is open, the spine is nice and long. Again, no tension through the trunk of the body, just nice and relaxed, even as you lengthen the breath. Pelvis relaxes, the glutes are relaxed. And notice your sit bones on the floor, on your mat, a connection down, a heaviness. As you relax through the pelvis, and the legs, and feet. And just noticing your arms, your hands, fingers, feel nice and relaxed. Just a few more rounds, long yogic breaths. And inhale nice and long through the nose. Nice big exhale through the mouth. Two more rounds. as we bring our hands together in front of our heart, getting ready to begin our practice. Let's briskly rub those palms together, starting to feel energy, heat building up between those palms, and placing those palms over our eyes as we open them back into the light and taking our hands away. Begin with our greeting of namaste, hello to you. Thank you for joining me. And we'll uncross and recross our legs. And we're going to just start with a bit of breath work again. So we're going to do some Kapalbhati and frontal brain cleansing. So quite an energizing breath work. So if you are doing this practice in the evening, maybe just sit the breath out and just continue with those long yogic breaths, nice and relaxed breaths. In the morning, really good for the morning as it really gets the energy levels up high. So Kapalbhati, if you haven't done that breath before, I will just demonstrate for a moment. So you take a nice big breath in through the nose. And then when you exhale, you're drawing the belly in a sharp exhale through the nose. So you're really pressing the belly in so you can feel those muscles contracting. You're almost doing some abdominal work as well. So it's really bringing the breath in. As you take the breath out, you bring the belly in, so it's kind of pushing the breath out. So nice big breath in. And you want to stay relaxed, try not to tense up as you get that breath coming out, as you take a nice big force out. And we'll continue for 10 times. So it is quite a fast breath. If you start feeling a bit lightheaded or nauseous, do take a break. And then come back to it when you're feeling a bit better, when you're feeling all right again. So in and out through the nose. Fill up the belly. And relax. We'll do another two rounds of 10 breaths. And maybe just have the hands on the belly just to feel it coming in and out, in and out. And off we go in your own time. If you want to go for longer, then do continue. Nice breath in through the nose. Fill up that belly and off we go. And relax. Final time. And relax. Just took a couple more breaths there, really getting that energy flowing. Good. Just sitting here for a couple of breaths. Nice big breaths. To relax out the belly. And hopefully you were not holding on to any tension, but if you were, just relax it all up. And then we're going to start with a little bit of warming up before we continue. So nice big circles with our chin from the right shoulder, take it all the way up and then circling it down the other side, keep the shoulders relaxed. Put two more big circles. Our final circle. And then when you're ready, turn to the chest, stop going in the opposite direction from those three nice big circles with that chin, releasing any tension and kinks in the neck. Opening the shoulders out. For our final round, and then let the chin rest towards the chest when we end, taking a big stretch through the back of the neck. And next inhale, take the chin up towards the ceiling. Try not to collapse into the back of your neck. Get a nice stretch through the throat. Good, release the chin back to center. A few big shoulder rolls. Take the hands onto the shoulders. Bring those elbows together and apart. Really exaggerating that movement. Stay nice and long through the spine. Maybe drawing that navel in to get the core supporting you. And then we'll take it in the opposite direction as we take the elbows back and then forward. Good. Bring the elbows back to center. And we're going to bring our legs into butterfly, so soles of the feet together. and just holding on to your ankles, to your feet, and just gently moving those knees up and down, loosening up the hips. Just let go of any tension in the pelvis. Sometimes when you're doing this, you may find you're tensing through the hips, the pelvis, just let it consciously relax. And just start slowing that movement down. You know, bring the knees up towards each other into tabletop or a few rounds of cat cow. So bring those wrists under shoulders, knees hip distance apart, pressing down through the hands, through the feet as we inhale, getting up towards the ceiling. Draw those shoulders down your back, tilt that elbow. And then as you exhale, press through your fingers, tuck the tailbone under, chin to the chest, maybe tuck the toes, give them a stretch. Two more rounds, nice big inhale, go in your own time, with your own breath, really stretching that navel down, exhale, rounding up the spine, stretching those toes, final time, nice big breath in, and a nice big breath out. And then we come back to a neutral spine, tiger pose, Virabhasana. With the legs, they're still continuing that cat-cow movement. As we inhale, leg, right leg curls up towards the ceiling, opening up the chest, gazing up. Maybe a little bit more difficult here, so really press through those hands, draw those shoulders down. Exhale, rounding up the spine, knee towards the forehead. Two more times, nice big open of the chest. The leg reaches up. Exhale, rounding up that spine, squeeze up the breath, final time. Exhale, leg comes back, neutral spine as we get ready to shift sides, inhaling left leg, opposite leg reaches up, open the chest, really use those shoulder muscles to open up, exhale, rounding up, press through those hands, knee to forehead, two more times, exhale, final one. He comes back to center, and we're going to come into and adjust it into a soft pigeon. So bring the right knee towards the right wrist, ankle across, and we're going to sit on the outside of that right leg and just bending the back leg. So we're in a nice soft pigeon pose here, still having the body turned towards that right knee. Right hand to the side of the right knee, left hand forward, wrist lined up with shoulder, and we're going to take a turn here. So gazing at your fingertips, so take a nice big breath in, and then start taking the hand behind you, following your fingers with your gaze as you exhale, inhaling back to the front, and then exhaling out. For one more time, inhaling forward, good, exhaling out. Good, come back to center, bringing the hands either side, down dog as we square the hips, tuck the back toe under, step back down dog, keeping the knees soft for the moment as we take a big stretch through that spine, press down through those fingers, get the belly, get the ribs and the top of the thighs as close together as you can, and then come back down onto our knees as we get ready to do the opposite side. So left knee goes towards the left wrist, right knee bends, and we sit on the left side. Again, our left hand is just supporting us, right hand is forward, lined up with our shoulder, gazing at those fingers, nice big breath in. On the exhale, so taking the hand behind you, inhaling, bringing it forward, exhale, twisting it round, final time, nice big exhale, and then bringing it to center again. Into down dog we go, so bringing the hips up, tuck the toe under, and step back into down dog. And this time, maybe start walking up those legs, straightening the knees a bit more, warming up those hamstrings, walking up that dog. Keep pressing through those hands and flattening out the back. Then come back to center, right heel goes up towards the ceiling, left heel down to the floor. Nice big stretch, bring the right foot through between the hands, bring the left knee down, lift up the chest, gazing ahead, left hand to the side of the right foot, right hand up towards the ceiling as we talk. And then release, bring that hand down, and we're going to step back, down dog. We'll take our eight-point pose, shift that weight forward into a high plank, pressing those heels away, bring the knees down, then touch down with your chest and chin for a little back bend. If that's too much, slide straight down onto your belly, sliding your legs back, lift the chest into a baby cobra, draw those elbows in, tuck the toes under, back to down dog. And then take the left heel up towards the ceiling, bringing the left foot through, right knee down, lifting up the chest, gazing ahead, right hand to the mat, left hand up. We twist, and then release, bring that hand down, and we'll step through into a forward bend, pressing down through those feet. Let's stop rising up through the spine, use those arms to bring your hands and energy back to the heart. We'll do one round of sun salutation, pressing down through your feet, opening up the palms, Tadasana. Let's interlace fingers, take a palm tree up towards the ceiling, palms up towards the ceiling, really pressing down through the feet, squaring palm tree as we sway over to the right, keeping the hips square, weight equal on both feet, chest is nice and open, back to center, to the other side as we exhale. Good. Coming back to center, release into chair as we bend the knees. Take that weight back, lift up the toes. Place the toes back down. We engage those inner thighs. Into a forward bend we go. Soften the knees. Let's step that right foot back, knees on the mat. Lifting up the chest, gazing ahead. Crescent moon brings the arms up as we gaze at those fingers. A gentle back bend. Try not to sink into your hips. And then release into down dog, stepping back, placing palms on the mat. And let's take our flow, eight-point pose, shift the weight forward, bring the knees down, touch down with your chest and chin for our little back bend. Slide the legs back, lift the chest, baby full cobra. The glutes, shoulders relaxed, elbows drawn in. Tuck the toes under, we're back to down dog. Let's step that right foot through between the hands, left knee comes down, gazing ahead, softening the shoulders, crescent moon, gazing up at those fingers, into a forward bend, stepping through, start rising up through that spine, pressing down through the feet, bring that energy all the way around to the heart, we'll end on the left side, so let's go into palm tree, interlace fingers, palms reaching up towards the ceiling, soften the shoulders. Swaying palm tree to the left this time. Back to center. And then to the right. Keeping the hips square, weight equal on either side. Chest nice and lifted. Back to center into chair. Let that weight sink back and lift up those toes. Into a forward bend. Soften the knees, fingertips on the mat, stepping back with the left leg, knee on the mat, chest arching. Into down, into crescent moon, we take the hands up, gazing at those fingers. A gentle back bend. Into down, dog, palms on the mat, stepping back. Eight-point pose, shift that weight forward, bring the knees down, but this time we're going to scoop the chest straight through, so elbows back and scoop the chest as we go straight into a baby or full cobra. And then come back to down dog. Step that left foot between the hands, right knee comes down, crescent moon, bring those arms up. Good. Ending in a forward bend as we step through. Stop pressing down to the feet, rising up through that spine. Hands come back to the heart. We're going to take a nice big step back from here with the left foot into warrior two. So 90 degrees with the back foot, front foot facing towards me. Engage through that right leg. Take those arms to either side. Soften the shoulders. Press down through that left foot, reverse warrior, palm right palm turns up, left palm down, the back leg, right palm over the head, continue to press into that right foot. Good, coming back to center, and come into triangle, so straighten that right knee, reach to the right, drop right hand down, left one. And keep the chest nice and open, shoulders stacked above shoulders. I feel like there's a wall behind you that you're leaning up against, so you're falling forward, the chest lifted. Continue to press through the feet and draw those inner thighs towards each other. Top arms straight up towards the ceiling. I really want to look with your head. Reverse triangle, stop pressing through those feet, rising up, legs stay exactly as they are, we just flip the arms over. And then come back to center, bend that right knee again, extended warrior. So you can either lean on top of the right leg, take the left arm past the head, or you can take the right arm all the way down, or you can bind and take the right arm underneath the leg and grabbing the hand, top hand behind. Keep the chest open if you have to bend forward to get underneath. And don't get a strap. Oops, there goes my foot. The thing, get a strap. Or just take the back hand and get it as close to you as you can if you can't quite find. And you'll start getting the space. Eventually, keep pressing through that right foot. So wherever you are, just take a moment with a relaxed breath. Top hand comes down. Bringing that right foot, let's step up into down dog, releasing those legs. And we'll take another little flow here, option for chaturanga as we come into a high plank, so either with your knees, also coming down with your chest into a baby full cobra, or you can even go into up dog. Back to down dog, tuck the toes under, back to down dog. Right foot steps once more between the hands. We're going to come into a warrior one. So bring the right foot slightly closer and drop that heel to 45 degrees. Or if you're a clock, if you imagine you were a clock, your back foot's pointing to 10 o'clock. So we come up, pressing through our feet, not forgetting that back heel. Reaching those arms up, squaring those hips off, back and forward, front to back. Eagle arms as we take the arms to either side. And we're going to take the left arm over, bring the right one under. If you can get your elbows to cross, go for a bind or two. If you're struggling to cross your elbows, just hold onto your shoulders. And then lift the elbows so you're getting a nice, a nice straightening through the top of the back. Adjust the pelvis into neutral so you're not overstraining. Then straighten the front leg as we bind forward, bring the elbows all the way into our pyramid pose here. Stay pressing through those feet, especially that back heel. And then stabilizing those legs. And then release the arms, soften that front leg, bring fingertips to either side as we're going to come into a standing split. So the ball of the back foot, bring the hands slightly forward, and then lift the back foot up. Wrists should be underneath your shoulders as we take a standing forward split. And straighten the front leg if you can still stay connected to your mat for support or keep it soft. Back leg comes all the way down. Take a moment in a forward bend. We're going to come into chair again, bend the knees, get that weight going back, bring the hands forward, lift up the toes. And as we exhale, straighten the legs and see if you can lift the heels up, strengthen those ankles, reaching back, lengthening the spine. And then relax, bring the feet back down and we'll step back with the right foot this time. We'll just come this way so I don't have my back towards you. The right foot steps back, 90 degrees, bend that left leg. Again, engage that inner thigh, press down through that right foot, soften those shoulders as we take the arms out of warrior two. Reversing, left hand down, right, left palm up, right hand goes down, left leg. And pressing into that front leg. Inhaling back to center, triangle pose, straighten the left leg, reach to the left, and drop left hand down, right arm. Again, just take a moment just to check where you are, where your positioning is, everything's feeling comfortable. No straining, nice big breaths. Reaching that top arm straight up towards the ceiling. And then we'll get to reverse. So gazing down, start coming up, press through those feet, legs stay exactly where they are. And just flip the arms, right arm down, left one over there. Good, coming back to centre. We're going to extend that warrior as we bend in that left knee. Again, option two, lean on top and take the top leg and take the arm across over the head. Or come down to the floor if you want to take it further. Or come into your bind and keep that chest lifted. Stay pressing down through your feet. Try not to fall into that inner arch of the back leg. And find your place. Take a moment to really settle in. Try not to sink into any hips. And lifted and long. Top arm starts coming down as we frame that left foot to step into down dog. Nice big step up. Or our little flow from here. Shift that weight forward. Chaturanga or come down with your knees. Scooping through baby or full cobra or up dog if you want to take the thighs up. Make it that a little bit stronger. Go back into down dog whenever you're ready. Keep that foot steps between the hands. As we come to warrior one, bring the right foot closer, drop that heel, pressing down, lifting the arms up, squaring the hips. Draw up through that pelvic floor, soften the shoulders. Eagle arms as we take our arms to either side. And this time the right arm is over the left one under, crossing elbows. One or two binds, not crossing elbows, just holding onto your shoulders instead. Lifting the elbows to the top of the back is nice and straight and long through the neck. Big breath. And then start straightening the front leg as we bring the elbows down. Gazing towards soft toe. Into our pyramid pose. Keep pressing through that back heel. Pressing down through the front foot. Good. Release the arms. Bring the hands. Soften the knee if you need to. Bring the hands down. Walking them ahead. As we switch, weight onto the front leg and take that standing split. And then release. Back leg comes all the way down and into a forward bend. Equal weight on either feet. And we're going to start rising up through that spine. Come into chair, sorry. You take the weight back. Bring the arms forward. Get the weight into your heels. Open up the chest. Bring the hands to the heart and we'll take a twist. So taking left elbow to between the legs, or get the legs closer, and then get it all the way to the right side. Press the palms into each other. Open up the chest. Next breath back to chair. Weight back, lift the toes. Toes come down, hands to the heart and right elbow, either between the legs or all the way across. Put the legs close together and take it all the way across, pressing into palms. Good, release back into chair. And then we're going to start straightening the legs, taking the arms behind us and see if we can lift the heels. Probably a bit more challenging if your legs are closer together. Press down through those toes, put the little muscle just above the knees. And release, heels come down, take a little shake, knee two, and we're going to come into a wide legged pose, so just stepping back, touch your other leg, say you're facing me or to the side, whatever is comfortable, a nice wide legged pose. We're going to start parallel feet, pressing through the outer edges, hands to the hips as we start hinging forward, lengthening that tailbone back, lengthening the arms forward. Take a nice stretch here to to the inside of the legs, through the spine. And then take the hands behind the back interlaced fingers, maybe to the opposite direction, with the opposite baby finger underneath. Squeeze the shoulders and fold right in. Pressing into those outer edges. And then release the hands down towards the mat if you need to soften your knees. We're going to come into a side squat, so turning your right toes off to one side and stop bending that right leg. Then we're going to come onto the heel of that left foot and flex it up. Just take a moment and you may need to adjust the right foot to get it into the right place so that your heel is coming down, but try not to fall into that instep. We're going to keep pressing through all four corners of the feet. You could maybe put a block or roll your mat up behind you to give some support to that heel. They can continue with lengthening the calf muscle and that Achilles tendon. If you can, and the heels on the floor, you can bring the hands up. If you can't quite make it there yet, just bring the hands to support you. I would avoid coming to just be on the ball of your foot because then you're not feeling that length through the back of the leg. So rather be here with support, just lengthening. Have a nice straight spine, keep flexing the opposite foot up, relaxing through the base of the body. Then release, bring that foot down as we come back to center again, bring our hands through, adjusting the right foot, and just moving the legs up from side to side as we get ready to switch sides, turning the left toes, take yourself over to the left. Again, take your time adjusting that foot, coming onto, flexing the right foot up onto the heel, the back of the heel, and then find your place wherever it is. Engage that inner thigh so the leg's not falling in. Stay nice and long through the spine. Keep flexing right foot up. Good. Let's release, bring the right foot down, coming to center again. Just parallel those feet, just move from side to side. And then come back to center. We're going to bring the feet slightly closer together as we come into Balasana yogic squat. The ankles just slightly wider than your hips. A couple of options. You can just come into a normal squat where the feet are slightly even wider and just bend. Let the weight sink back, bend the knees, and then you just place your hands on top of your legs for some support. If you can't quite come all the way into Malasana, this is enough for the moment. Still keeps the length through the back. Otherwise, if you're coming into Malasana, take a moment to adjust your feet, bring the legs slightly closer, this feels comfortable, and just come and sit in Malasana. So again, up to you. hands supporting you if your heels are not quite are not supported, or getting that support underneath. Get a cushion, blocks, roll up your mat to get the support under the heels, and then you can bring the palms together, palms to the inside of the legs. Just for a few breaths, just lift that tailbone straight and down as the spine lengthens. And pressing through the feet, we're not falling back. Staying nice and stable. And then release into a forward bend. Bring the hands down straight to the legs. Take a moment in a forward bend. Again, option two, walk out the legs if you wish. Or just stay still, completely up to you. Keep the knees slightly soft. Just to keep the hips stacked over the knees stacked over ankles. We're going to go one more time into our yogic squat. So coming down, or just into a normal squat, whatever feels better for you. And then if you want to, we can come into a balance and come into our crow pose or crane pose. Again, up to you. You can just stay here. We can just play around with it. you want to have the elbows nice and bent, so you have a little step at the back of your arm, top of your arm, creating a little step. You press through the hands, have that weight going into the fingers. And then you can either bring the knees, the more advanced version, although I always struggle with the beginner's version and putting the knees on the back of my arms was what always the easiest for me. But just go with what you can do, or we bring the little, the inside of the leg where the knee bends to the outside, again to the back of the arms. So we're either here and we're shifting the weight forward, play around, maybe one foot, maybe the other, or we bring the knees coming to the slightly stronger version, again press through those fingers. And it's really about getting that balance. So don't look down, you want to look slightly ahead. If you look down, the head will pull you down. And you want to get that tailbone into center. And then once it's in center, the lifting of the feet will just come naturally. So just play around with that for a moment. Or just stay in your yogic squat. Whatever works. Come in and out of it. Just for a few breaths. Just going for a full practice that I will do in one of my classes, face-to-face classes, which hopefully will be happening soon. Good, and then we're going to come into down dog, and when you're down, start with rising, and then come into down dog. Good. Take a moment, into down dog we come, and wherever you are in your practice. Meeting here in down dog for a moment. Or you could go into child's pose if you prefer. And we're going to come into pigeon. So take the right heel up towards the ceiling. Or you can come down onto your knees if you prefer. And then bring that right knee towards your right wrist. Straighten the back leg. And this time, if we feel comfortable, hips are square. If not, you can either bring a cushion to place underneath the right hip, the right thigh, or you can just sit on the outside, as we did in the beginning, the softer version. So pick your options. They relax through their shoulders, relax through the hips. And we stay here for the moment. Let's see if we can do a little backbone, just make a little bit more energizing. So bring the back leg, bring that left heel towards you. Weight transfers onto your left hand. See if you can take your right hand across. You may be able to reach your toes, maybe just your heel, or just grab onto your leggings. You want to try not to be twisted too far back, so try and keep this shoulder square, and we're just reaching up. Really creating the length through that arm. The shoulder in the socket, so drawing that shoulder back, even as we press the toe into the hand into the foot. We're just bringing the shoulder, keeping it in its socket. Keeping the hips square. And then we'll release the leg, bring that hand forward. Maybe come into more of a relaxed pigeon, come down onto your forearms. Maybe go all the way down and just relax for a couple of breaths. Letting go of any tension in the lower back and the hips. Releasing that sciatic nerve. And then let's come back up onto our hands when we take our next breath. And we're going to come into down dog, three-legged dog. So tuck the back toe under. Take that leg all the way up to the ceiling and just flip it back, keeping those shoulders square. And bring that leg down for down dog. Taking a little flow, let's shift that weight forward. And in fact, we're just going to lower ourselves down, whether you come down with your knees or with your chest. And just stay in a baby cobra. So come all the way down, lengthen the legs back. And those hands just to either side of your chest. We'll just stay here in baby cobra. Draw those elbows in as we inhale, press through the hands. Start lifting the chest a little bit further. Into a fuller cobra if your back allows. And then as we exhale, coming down. Let's do that two more times. Inhaling, pressing through the hands. Either staying in baby cobra or from fuller up. Into fuller cobra. And then coming all the way down. For our last time, inhaling. Exhaling, release down. And then tuck the toes under, back to down dog, pressing through to down dog. Getting ready to do the left leg, so left heel up. I'll just come down onto both knees and then bring that left knee towards the wrist and take the right leg back. Square through the hips. Take a moment just to relax into the pose, relax those shoulders. Switching your weight onto the right side, bring that left foot towards you and see if you can, right foot towards you. You're going to reach back with that left hand. Again, trying not to pull back. Stay nice and square, pressing foot into hand, hand into foot, drawing shoulder into its socket. Even if you can't reach anywhere, any part, as long as you're just reaching back in that same action going, still lengthening, making space. And then let's release, straighten the back leg, bring that hand forward. If you've got more room, you can always adjust the ankle, bring it closer to the wrist. And then either coming down onto your forearms, or going straight down into the full pose. And just relax and pigeon for a few breaths. And then our next breath, we're going to come back up onto our hands and come into that three-legged dog. So tuck the back toe under, press through those hands, left heel goes up, and then flips back towards your sit bones as we open up those inner thighs, shoulder square, and then release, bring that leg back down, into down dog, coming down onto our bellies again, and this mat's a little bit not my usual mat, a bit slippery, shift that weight forward. And then option again, chest first or knees as we come and lie on our bellies, on our chest. Take the hands behind us, interlace those fingers if that feels comfortable, rise up the chest. If you need support, just keep the hands to either side. Pressing through the pelvis, pubic bone into the floor, easing those shoulders back, and then relax. Make a pillow with your hands and relax your back, and wriggling it out for a moment. And then come back to center. We're going to bring the hands into locust pose. So hands either coming up, coming under your thighs, facing up to support your lift, or if you don't need the support, you can just bring the hands to either side. We're going to go one leg at a time, so starting with our right leg as we inhale, our right leg goes up. Hips stay square, and the leg just goes up. Use that right hand if you need the support. If not, just press the hands into the mat. You can have your chin down, forehead down, or you can have your head lifted. Whatever feels good for your back. Keep the glutes relaxed. Just feel those back muscles tensing up, working, strengthening. And then release, bring the right leg down. And get ready to switch sides. Inhale, left leg goes up. Relax into the pose as we exhale. For a couple of breaths. Good, release, bring the leg down. Take a pillow with your hands again, rock out your back. See if we can combine the arms and the legs. If not, just keep the hands again underneath if you need the support and use the hands to support your legs because we're going to take both legs up together. Otherwise, if you're okay, you can reach the hands back, palms facing each other, start lifting the chest. And then as you exhale, lift the legs, draw that navel in so we're engaging that core to support the back as we we come into the full locust pose. Keep reaching back, pressing that pubic bone into the floor, rising those legs up. Just for a couple more breaths. Just work with whatever works for you. Final breath. And then release. Legs come down. Make a pillow with your hands. Rock out the back. Maybe even one screen wipe, bring the legs. That feels good for your back. And then come back to center. Into a wide-legged child's pose to bring ourselves up. Knees apart, toes touching. Into child's pose, a nice big stretch through the back. Relax the arms, the shoulders. Take a few long breaths. Feel that rise and fall through the spine. And then our next breath. So let's stop rising up to our spine as we come up to seated. We're going to come and lie on our backs. Just give our back a little massage. Bring the knees up towards the chest. And just take a gentle rock from side to side. As we come back to center, bring the feet to the mat. As wide as your mat, wider than your hips. Take the hands to the sides. I'm just going to drop the knees into a supine spinal twist to the left. Shift your shoulders and look to the right. Just relax in a spinal twist. Knees come back to center. Chest comes back to center, neck back to center, and then release to the opposite side. Lift the legs up over to your right. Shift your shoulders and look to your left. Nice big relaxing breath here. Good, bringing the chest, the neck back to center, knees come back up, bring those knees up towards your chest, take your arms around your legs, take a nice big breath in. As you exhale, squeeze those legs into your abdomen, release that lower back, final lunge. We get ready to end our practice in Shavasana, horse pose. Straightening out the legs, making space. Let the arms just open up to the sides, palms facing up. Adjust your chin so your neck is nice and long and relaxed. Closing your eyes, or soft eyes. And just completely letting go. Just feel the body getting that little bit heavier. Just noticing it as it relaxes down. Nice and soft, nice and heavy. Let the feet just flop out to the sides. Let the legs completely relax. Let the pelvis just gently relax down as the belly relaxes. The tension through the trunk of the body. Let the spine gently relax. Shoulders are relaxed. Arms are heavy, they gently relax, the fingers draw you down as you totally relax, face is relaxed, a gentle space between your teeth as your jaw relaxes, forehead, nice and relaxed, eyes are heavy in their sockets as they totally relax. Letting go of thoughts, letting your mind relax, completely letting go. Just for the next few precious moments, totally relax. the world, just floating away completely relaxed. Every time a thought pops into your head, just let it go again. Just come back to relaxing. Feeling heavy and relaxed. Now we will leave you here in Shavasana. Thank you for joining me today. I hope you enjoyed the practice. I hope to see you again soon. Namaste.